You know, those of us in the media are so lucky. We have the North American International Auto Show all to ourselves for two whole days. Media previews, they call it. The public can't come in here until Saturday. All day today, the coverings were being taken off brand new cars, and it was absolutely fantastic. But what do? I zero in on the car that won the Indianapolis 500 this year. Dario Franchitti was driving this car. And when it was over and he was in victory lane, they gave him the Borg-Warner Trophy, which to racing fans is kind of like what the Stanley Cup is to hockey fans. Now, when I first saw the Borg-Warner Trophy in the late 1970s, it was a lot smaller than it is now. As it was the case with the Stanley Cup, they've had to keep adding to it. And as you can see, it's getting bigger and bigger as the years roll by and more people are presented it. More male faces, and maybe someday eventually a female face. One of the faces on there, by the way, the Indy 500 was won in 1946 by a gentleman named George Robson, who lived for 11 years in Toronto. His brother Hal Robson also drove in that 1946 race. Didn't do as well as his brother, but Hal Robson was born in Toronto and was in fact the first Toronto-born driver to race at Indianapolis. Paul Tracy and Scott Goodyear and the rest of those guys came years later. So that's the way it's been. Day one here at the media preview days of the North American International Auto Show. Day two is still to come, and we'll continue to bring wall-to-wall coverage here at wheels.ca. Norris McDonald, editor of Toronto Star Wheels, reporting to you from Detroit.